Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain you about gantry gutter design in design of steel structure. So before that I'll show you how the gantry gutter looks like. So this is our gantry gutter. Have you seen this? This is the gantry gutter, and here the cabin is there, and this is the hook portion, and this is the crane gutter. Okay, this crane gutter acts on this gantry gutter, and there are wheels are there, so it will move like this to carry the loads. Okay, so now we are going to design these gantry gutters. In given question, span of gantry gutter is 6.5 meters, and these are all given data. Span of crane gutter is 16 meters and crane capacity is 250 kilonewtons, like that some details are given. So here first we need to calculate moments. So nothing but load for maximum moment. So maximum moment loads we need to calculate, that is crane capacity, which is given. Crane capacity is 250 kilonewtons plus self weight of trolley, that is 50 kilonewtons. So I got 250 plus 50, 300 kilonewtons. So total, next self weight of the crane gutter is 200 kilonewtons, which is given in question. Next, maximum reaction on gantry gutter. That is, the moving load should be close to gantry gutter as possible. That is, here if suppose the gantry gutter is, the crane here, it moves like this. And one end is here and other end is here. I mean, two supports are there. So the minimum approach of this gutter is 1 meter. Why? Because I show you the hook portion will approach is 1 meter. Here minimum hook approach is 1 meter, which is given in question. So up to here the hook will allow. Okay, so like that we will draw. For this we need to find out RA and RB reactions. So I am taking moment at B. So moment at B. So while taking moment at B, at that point the moment is zero. Here the moment is zero. And the moment formula is force into perpendicular distance. So the force is RA is one force, RA into perpendicular distance. This is the force and this is the perpendicular distance. RA into 16, which is RA into 16, which is clockwise direction, that's why it is positive. And next minus 300, which is anti-clockwise direction at B point. So minus 300 into 15, and minus 200 is also anti-clockwise direction into perpendicular distance is 8. So I'll show you. So this is 300, and which is anti-clockwise direction to this point, and 200 also anti-clockwise direction to this point. So force into perpendicular distance is half of the distance, that is 8, and perpendicular distance of this one is 300 into 15. So I got RA value as 381.25 kilonewtons. And next we need to calculate load on gantry gutter from each wheel. So 381.25 divided by 2, 190.63 kilonewtons. And next, factored wheel load, that is 1.5 multiplied 190.63 into 1.5, I got 286 kilonewtons. Next, we need to find out the maximum moment due to moving loads. So here, the load is moving. So the maximum moment for the moving loads, when the center of gravity of wheel load and the wheel are equidistant from the center of gutter. So here, this is total gutter, that is RA and RB. Here half of this, that is center, is this C point. In this D and E point is the wheel load. Okay, so here I place this wheel load. In question, so from wheel to wheel distance is 3.5 meters, which is mentioned in question. So I placed this wheel to wheels here. So 3.5 meters. In this 3.5, I'm dividing like this. So this is 3.5 meters, and from here to this point 1.75 and 0.875 and 0.875. So total we will get just 3.5, and remaining portion, this total distance is 3.25 and 3.25, so 2.375 and remaining is 0.625. okay, so after that we need to calculate moments. So moment at A, same here I am taking moment at this point. So moment at A is force into perpendicular distance, this is the force and which is anti-clockwise direction, minus RB into 6.5, total distance. And next, plus 286 into 0.625. 286 is this one, clockwise direction, so positive distance is 0.625. like that I calculated E point also. Okay, this is clockwise direction and I added all the distances, so I got RB value as 209 kilonewtons. After calculating these moments, we need to calculate the maximum moment at E and moment due to impact. So here maximum moment at E, that is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. The force is 209 and the perpendicular distance is 2.375, so I got this value. And moment due to impact, so moment due to impact loads in code specifying that 25% of the maximum moment. So 25% nothing but 0.25 into 496.375, I got this value. And I am assuming the self weight, that is 2 kN per meter. So dead load due to self weight plus rails, so 2 plus 0.3, which is given in question, this 0.3 value. And factor dead load is factor of 1.5, 2.3 into 1.5, I got 3.45 kN per meter. And next, moment due to dead load, WL square by 8 formula. So W value, we know that this is 3.45 into L is 6.5, which is given in question, and 8. So I got the value. Moment due to vertical loads, I am adding all the loads and I got 638.689 kN meter. And next, maximum moment due to horizontal force. So horizontal force for transfers to rails, which is mentioned in tabular form, that is 10% of weight of trolley plus load lifted. I'll show you the tabular form here. For electrical operated cranes, 25% of maximum static wheel loads, and for hand operated cranes, 10% of maximum wheel loads, like that he mentioned. So here the horizontal force transfers to rails, that is 10% of weight of trolley and weight lifted, so that's why I took it as 10%. So I got 30 kilonewtons. And next, here we are assuming double flamed wheels, this is distributed over 4 wheels. So I am dividing this 30 divided by 4, I got 7.5 kilonewtons. After that factored 11.25 kilonewtons. And the maximum moment in gantry girder, the position of loads, we need the moment. Actually the diagram is, we got the value, that is I'll show you. So here another force is also there, that is a horizontal force, this one, sorry, here an horizontal force is also there, that's why we are resolving this maximum moment of gantry girder. I am proportioning the value, that is 11.25, which we got the value, and divided by 286, that is nothing but the load. So horizontal load is 11.25 and 286 is the vertical load. By proportioning, I am getting the MY, 19.525 kilonewton meter. So after doing these values, we need to calculate shear forces. So here is our diagram. So 286 kilonewtons and 286 kilonewtons, 3.5 and 3, 6.5 meters total. So vertical shear force, vertical shears due to loads, that is 286 plus 286 into 3 divided by 6.5, I got 418 kilonewtons. And next, vertical shear due to impact, same in previous step, we multiplied with 25%, like that I have done. And next, vertical shear due to self weight, so 3.5 into 6.5 divided by 2, 11.21 kilonewtons. And again I am adding total vertical shear. So by proportioning the lateral shear due to surge, surge is nothing but a horizontal loads, so 11.25 divided by 286 into 148.4, so I got this value. And we need to select a trial section. Why? Because we don't know which section we need to choose, so that's why I'm just choosing a trial section. Before choosing the trial section, the code is specifying that we need to satisfy these conditions. So L by 12, that is span by 12, and L by 25, that is 260 mm, I got. So here I'm choosing ISWB 600 with ISMC 300 on compression flange. I will show you the diagram. So these are the properties of ISWB 600 and ISMC 300. Okay, so these values are available in steel tables book. We need to find out. So here this is the ISWB 600 I section and this is ISMC 300 section. So here I choose these two trial sections and I wrote all the properties here which is available in steel tables book. So after that we need to find out the Y bar, nothing but centroid. So we all know that centroid formula A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 by total area. So here A1 is nothing but we are choosing one section, that is let the distance of neutral axis from the extreme fiber of tension flange be Y bar. So here neutral axis is here, so this is one section and this is another section. So by using this I am finding out Y bar. Okay, so this A1 value, that is area value available in steel tables book, already I listed these properties 17038. Okay, this is for ISWB 600. So I am taking ISWB 600 values, A1 Y1. So Y1 value is 300, that is nothing but half of this section. And next 4564 is area of this this section into 600 plus 7.6 minus 23.6, that is nothing but 600 is total distance plus 7.6 is thickness of this this section and 23.6 is CYY value. Okay, so I got 360 mm. After that I need to calculate moment of inertia. We know the formula moment of inertia, Izz equal to Ixx plus A into Yc square. So these values are also available in these properties. Have you seen this? This is Ixx value for 600 and 300 Ixx value. So by using the formula Ixx plus A into Yc square, I calculated this Izz. After that Ze, that is Izz by Ymax, I got this value. And next for compression flange about Yy axis, same I'm calculating for compression flange about Yy axis. The formula is BDQ by 12. We know that for rectangular the moment of inertia formula is BDQ by 12. So by using that formula I'm going to calculate the moment of inertia for compression flange about Yy axis. So I got this value. And next Ze for compression flange, so I got this value. After calculating these values, we need to calculate plastic section modulus. So the code is specifying that whether the section is plastic or semi-plastic or compact, like that we need to select. So for that purpose we need to do, I'm adding the total area of the section, that is this is having one area and this is having another area. I added all the values. And next, plastic neutral axis be at a distance of YB from tension flange. So this is the tension flange and YP value we need to find out. So by doing this multiplications and additions we will get this value, that is this YP distance is here minus 21.3 value. We know the 21.3 value is thickness of the flange into 11.2 value, that is thickness of the web, this thickness of the web, plus 250 into 21.3. Nothing but L into B formula, area formula I am calculating, and total area by divided by 2, half of that area here. So 2160 2 by 2, so I got YP value as 510.2. like that I calculated. This 250 is yield stress value, that is Fy value. So after calculating this I am calculating again the moments. So moment, so force into perpendicular distance formula, like that by using those all these values I calculated this. You just refer the steel tables book for these values, 21.3 and 600, 21.3, 11.2, these values are available in steel tables book. Okay, after calculating all these, I mean for this section and for this section, for this section and these sections, I am calculating all the moments. So I got 4686450 into Fy. Okay, Zp equal to, our formula is Zp equal to Mp by Fy. So Zp value and Zp equal to Mp value. We know that this is the Mp value. I substituted this and Fy get cancelled. I got this value. After calculating this plastic section modulus, and again we need to calculate the top flange. For top flange, we just now we calculated for tension flange, and we are going to calculate the same moments for top flange. So that is nothing but first we calculated this portion, the bottom flange, and next top flange. So this top flange, same moments I calculated. After calculating these moments, we need to check whether the moment capacity is okay or not. So by referring table 2 in page number 18, ISWB 600 for the section, and the table specifies that limiting width ratios, that is B by T less than 8.4. We need to satisfy this condition. So B value we know that 250 minus 11.2 by 2 into 21.3. So I got 5.6, less than 8.4 satisfied. And next D by T less than 84. So I got this value. So both conditions are satisfied. Next, hence it is a plastic section. You just refer table number 2, you will get the idea. So local moment capacity for bending in vertical plane. So this formula is available in code book, page number 53, 8.2.1.2 class. These formulas are all available. So to find out the moment capacity, Fy by Zp by gamma m0. This is the partial safety factor value, which is available in table number 5. So I got 1065.1 kilonewton meter. After that, we need to calculate this one. This entire formula available in this page number. For top flange also, we need to calculate. The same formula I am using, and I am calculating for top flange. So I got this one. After calculating these two values, we need to find out the combined local capacity. So this is the condition which is given in code book, mz by mdz plus my by mdy less than or equal to 1. So I got 0.865, which is less than 1. Hence it is okay. And next we need to calculate buckling resistance. So in class 8.2.2.1, page number 54, the formula is given for buckling resistance. So md equal to beta b zp fbd. So here beta b is 1 for plastic section. This is also available in code book. So here if I wrote 1, the equation is like this. So if we need to find out the fbd value, we are going to find out the fcrb value. This formula is available in code book in page number 54. So by finding out fcrb, I mean by using this equation, we are going to find out this FCRB value. So FCRB, LLT is nothing but the span of the girder. So we know that 6500 mm, and Young's modulus, and with height of the flange, that is 600 plus 7.6, and next IY is the moment of inertia. All values are available. Okay, and area, total area, and radius of gyration, that is root over I by A, moment of inertia by area. So I got this value. After calculating all these values, I am substituting these equations. I am substituting all the values in this equation. So I got this value. After finding this FCRB value from table 13A, by doing interpolation. So interpolation between this FCRB and KL, we are having the, in table, we are having these FCRB values by doing interpolation. By referring 13A table, we are going to find out FBD value. So I got FBD value as 167.8 Newton per mm square. So I substitute this value in MDZ equation. So this is our equation. So I got 786.39 kilonewton meter, which is greater than 638.689 kilonewton meter, which we calculated previously. Here we calculated 683.8 kilonewtons. So that is capacity, moment capacity previously we calculated. So that is the value. So check for biaxial bending. Next, these are all steps for gantry girder. That's why we are calculating all these checks. So for biaxial bending, MDY equal to FYZY by 1.1. So I got, I'm finding ZY value, that is IY by 150. So I got this value.
And next MDY, I substitute this equation, Fy is yield stress value. So I got 167.65 kilonewton meter. After that, again, I'm using this equation. I'm finding which is less than 1. So hence it is okay. And next, check for shear. So all these checks we need to do. If in examination, if we ask about to do the checks, you need to do. Otherwise, no need of doing the checks. So in class 8.4, page number 59, by referring this, we need to find out the shear capacity. AVFYW by root 3 into gamma m naught. This formula is available in this page number. So AV is nothing but area, that is L into B, 600 into 11.6, and FY is 250 divided by root 3 into 1.1. So I got 913 kilonewtons, which is greater than VZ value. Already we calculated. Hence it is okay. And next, by using welding, we are going to design these gutter. So all the values we are available. So we need to find out the shear stress, Q equal to V by BI into A into Y bar. So here Q value, that is V value, we know that already we calculated, that is 533.71. Here I'll show you the value. And next, 1127.452, that is B into I, we know that. And A area is 4564 into Y bar is centroid, we already find out. So that is 484.6 Newton per mm. After calculating all these values, by doing welding, we calculated this. If S is the size of weld provided on each side, the code is specified. We know that 0.7 times the throat thickness, the formula is available. Fu by root 3 into 1 by gamma ml. So I substituted all the values. So we need to find out S value, that is size of the weld. 265.12 S Newton per mm. I'm equating this to shear force, I got S value. But the code is specifying that in table 21, in welding section, the code is specifying that we need to provide 5 mm weld, which is minimum on both sides. So I'm doing that 1.83 by 5, which is percentage of welding, and I got 36.6. That is, I'm taking 40% weld. And minimum weld we need to provide is 5 mm as per code. So after that, check for web buckling. So web, we need to calculate, check for web buckling. So D is 600 minus 2 into 21.3 plus 17. That is nothing but total web is 600. In that, two flanges involved. So that's why I'm detecting those 2 into 21.3 plus 17. So I got this value. And thickness is 11.2 mm. So in code, it is specifying that for web buckling, we need to satisfy this condition, that is D by TW less than 67. So D value we know that, and T value is know that 11.2, that is thickness of the web 46.7, so which is less than 67. After that, check for deflection. This is the final step. In table number 6, page number 31, for check for deflection, the permissible limit is L by 750, that is span by 750. In code book, it is available. So span is 6500 by 750. I got 8.66 mm. So deflection requirement is satisfied. Hence use ISWB 600 with ISMC 300 on compression flange. So these are the steps in gantry gutter design. In examination, if we specify to do all the checks and all the steps we need to do. Otherwise, no need of doing all the things. So you just simply calculated the shear and moments and reactions. After that only you need to do the checks. So this is the gantry gutter problem. I hope you understood this. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.